She's returned, Geralt. After all these years.
The man who meets the hunt returns to this world. I returned.
Alright guys and ladies, welcome back my friends to a little more Witcher 3 Wild Hunt gameplay. We are, night has just recently crawled up on us here, and it's a spooky place to be here on the outskirts of the bog, yeah, middle of the night. We're in a tiny little village, I think it's called Down Warren, and this village clearly has its problems. So much so that it has drawn the attention of the Crones of Crookback Bog. There is something, I think, killing the villagers here. Something, I'm not sure what exactly everything was that the Elderman said, but he's given us direction across the bog. Let's go into the map really quickly, because there's a couple of things happening here. I also picked up a contract off the notice board, the only activity listed on the notice board. And this is the contract swamp thing. Now I did go in and I checked my journal, my various quests. I wanted to make sure that this was a reasonably leveled, baddie or mission or contract, right? So the suggested level on this was 12. We just recently cracked the 9 level, so I think I'm probably safe to head this way, and that's in fact what I'm going to do. Now, as far as the other mission goes, or to do with the Crones of Crookback Bog, and progressing things with them, and discovering this whole madness this darkness that's affecting Down Warrens and the villagers that live there, and the bog in general. It's over here somewhere. So we're working both ends of the bog, the entirety of it. Now what I'm gonna do, we're gonna set off right here and probably work these two points of interest just for shits and giggles. Yes, and then we'll head south, venture south back into the swamp, back into the bog, and try and take down this swamp thing. All right, now first things first, I also noticed that I don't think that there's any sort of armor or smith in town, so I'm pretty well beat as far as getting repairs go, but I do have a couple of amateur weapon repair kits, and the one thing that I noticed is really hurting, the Viper Silver Sword down to 67%, so I'd probably be best to use both of these right now, and let's do it. So that should be up at, 82, okay, so I've got space to use this final one. And let's do it. All right, we're looking good. The set of armor was looking pretty solid. I've got my backup set. I've got my backup steel sword. The one thing I really need to keep an eye on, clearly, is that silver sword right now. And I think I'm probably good to just kind of set off here now. We'll grab the, we'll get the torch out. And you know what? Do I need that bloody green lamp in there any longer? I don't think I do. What I'd like to be able to do is put my, because I've got a third bomb, don't I? Where is it now? I don't think it will actually. It's not gonna go. All right. Well, that's a real shame. Get this bloody green lamp. Okay. Well, let's get the first point of interest marked up, and let's head out of town. I do have a merchant here. In fact, Geralt was stalking the man. Yeah, he's posted up outside his house. Look at this. Is that him right in there? It is. It's him right there. Geralt was peeking in the door. The man clearly turned him away. He said, "No, business hours. Read the bloody sign, you whoreson." And he turned the Witcher aside. Yes. The Witcher, now infuriated, is considering burning the man's house down with a well-placed Igni sign. But no. We'll let him live on this eve. I may have use for him yet. Actually, my weight isn't looking too bad, so no big hassle, no big worry. Although I would imagine we'll have a good game of Gwent waiting for us when I finally do return to Down Warren. Yes. Alright, a little wolf's bane. You know what, I think of all the supplies I have, the flowery supplies rather than the mushrooms, of all the supplies I have, I think wolf's bane is probably what I have the most of right now. Oh, look at this, another one! No. No way. Oh, bloody hell. I wonder if it's because I left the game, because this is the exact same spot where we were doing battle, you know? I wonder if it's because I backed out of the game and then came back in, but he's back here already. It just seems a little odd, you know? It wasn't long since we fought this creature. But that's fine. I'm always up for a good fight with a wyvern. They're enough of a challenge, but they just make for a really great epic battle. But at this level, you know, at level 9, solo one-on-one, where I kind of excel. Probably my strongest combat is one-on-one against formidable foes, you know. The packs seem to be what threw me in, you know, the most... The packs seem to be what give me the most trouble. Oh, wow. But stuff like this, and going up against noon wraiths, and they're a little strong. Oh, he's a spitter, too. Look at this. Screwball, yo. What happened there? I'll tell you, and I was just thinking about that fight we had with the other wyvern and the three harpies. You know what could be happening here? This could be the wyvern's, the first one's mage or something. Yes, that's how we'll explain this away. Alright, wonderful. Wonderful. And what have you? What have you, wyvern? What have you? Monster saliva, a tongue. We didn't get the mutagen. And an egg. Good. Alright. Yeah, I was just thinking about it, just as I was rolling around the corner. In fact, I was just getting ready to discuss that, you know, that great fight between the three harpies, the wyvern, and Geralt. I mean, it was just like the perfect time of day. It just looked so slick, so perfect. You know? Up on that ridge. Oh, wow. It was a great time. If you could sum up The Witcher with one image, well, so far that would be a still frame from that fight at the right angle. Would be what I'd use, you know. In fact, it would probably make thumbnail. Well, maybe. Where am I going? I'm on track. Keep kind of glancing up. I see that my waypoint is pointing me elsewhere. But no, I'm making this hill climb for a reason. Oh my, is that where we're heading? You know what I think it is? Oh, way up there, I mean. Up on that peak where all the, oh, there's something ablaze up there. Look at that. Alright, well, you better get the lead out. We're on our midnight mountain climb here. Witcher Geralt Hertz, mountain man extraordinaire, yes. You've got some big shoes to fill there, Geralt. Some big shoes. Oh, it's a place of power. Fantastic. Get up there. There you go. Look at this. He really is the mountain man. Careful now. A treacherous trail along the spine here.
Place of power.
This is beauty.
Should draw from it.
Oh, and a little bit of loot. An enhanced saddle. I think I've already got that. Now, what is this? Yarden. All right. But more importantly, the ability point. Oh, this is quite nice. All right, what am I going to spend it on? You know what I think? You know what I'm going to do? I'm gonna level up the Igni. And you know why I'm going to do it? Just so that I can unlock this next line, just to see what some of them are. So what are we going to get here now? Damage dealt by Igni also permanently weakens enemy armor. Good. Effect scales with sign intensity up to a maximum of 45%. And of course, the stamina regeneration gets another boost of 0.5 per second. A rate of regeneration of 0.5 per second. Okay. Not going to waste too much time here. Let's just do it. Commit to it. And actually, what I really want to see is what some of these are now. Alright, so the Ard Sweep. Ard will strike all opponents in a certain radius. Knockdown chance is 21% lower. So... Do we suffer a little bit there because of that? Not sure. I'm not sure if I'm reading that right. Anyway, fire stream emits a continuous stream of fire that damages enemies. Yes. Good lord. Magic trap damages and slows all enemies within a 10-yard radius. Destroys projectiles passing through the area as well. Awesome. Creates an active shield, maintaining it and blocking attacks. Drains stamina. Damage absorbed by the shield restores player vitality. Wow. And the puppet. Targeted enemy briefly becomes an ally and deals 20% more damage. That's pretty good. There's some nice ones in that line. Oh my. Oh my! Am I ever happy that I got that open now. Alright, something to look forward to. And there we go. So we have... Yeah, that's precisely what I was after. We'll stop by this one. And we'll be down in the swamp. Well. Before breakfast. Yes, we will. Perhaps we'll have this swamp thing dealt with. Look at Geralt, sir. Would you like some skis, a skateboard, or something? No, that's how he rolls. In fact, that's how he slides, yes. Going all Far Cry on this. Oh, oh. You've broken the game, Geralt. You've broken it.
I returned.
Alright, we're back. We're back. And it wasn't necessarily easy getting back here either. Had a few things I had to take care of because, well, because there was no autosave that came in after assigning the point, after battling the wyvern, after you know, praying or meditating at this place of power. After simply mounting this mountain, yes, and claiming the peak. No autosave. So I was back at the village, of Downworn, and I had to battle the wyvern again and make my repairs and, you know, came up here. And assigned the point in the same slot, so nothing's changed. The only thing that really did change, just, you know, this random crash, I don't know where it came from, or what necessarily prompted it, but, you know, in an attempt to get up the mountain a little faster, I cut a few corners over here, trying to make the climb. There we go. We see Geralt in his greatness yet again. As he comes sliding down the mountain with some serious style, yes. No, I was trying to come up the mountain a little bit faster, and like I said, basically cutting corners, and I came up at a very sharp angle here in relation to the town, and I stumbled across this bad boy. You know, we've got some sort of an open cave. Now, I didn't really, you know, there's been no exploration done. I saw it, I took a quick look at it, and I figured I would wait for all of you to return before exploring deeper. We could have a bear in here, Geralt, so be careful. Really? An illusion, you say?
Someone placed an illusion here.
Awesome. I finally get to use this little thing. Oh, damn. I have to thank Keira next time I see her. Well, it's definitely no bear cave. No. Whatever lives here is far more sinister. Yes. Prepare yourself. There's dark magic at play, Geralt. Alright, somebody fell here. Somebody fell. Alright, I'm not seeing anything. Well, we're seeing a little sparkles. We're seeing a few sparkles over there in the distance. I'm hearing something. I don't know if it's topside. No, there's definitely something down here. There is definitely something down here, girl. What are we dealing with here? Oh! What is that thing? What the hell is that? Put the torch away, Geralt. What is that? Ekamar or something like that. He looks all spectral, you know? I don't know what to think here. Oh! Well, something's gotta change. Something's not working. Like, it's just way too dark here. I can't see a damn thing. I don't wanna have the torch, because then I can't block. I've limited abilities with the sword. We will guzzle a cat potion. Seems perfect time for it. We'll get this bad boy in. And is there anything else I should do? You know, what do I have here? Hangman's Venom. I've got Vampire. I've got Hybrid. Elementa. You know, that's what that thing reminds me of. Like an Elementa of some kind. Alright, let's try it. To have a bit of this on the sword. Might not be the best choice. It can't do any harm, though, you know. And we've got the Tawny Owl. And there we go. We're setting ready. Okay, where are you, creature? Now, am I going to have to trap him up? Because he definitely looked to be spectral in nature. Level 11. Gonna be a bit of a challenge, methinks. Did I lose my shield here? Apparently I have. Come now, creature. He's not the sharpest knife in the drawer, and this is your lair. He's clearly lost down here. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Awesome. Oh, he's paying for it. He's paying the mighty price here against the Witcher. He has fallen into my trap. Yeah, the trap definitely was working wonders there. Drop it again, Witcher. Forcing him into a more solid form. Oh, we took a little bit. Oh, damn, did we ever take a bit there. Get out of there, Witcher. Stick and move, sir. Drink him if you got him. Get that swallow in. I'm mucking about here now. I hope the oil is doing a little something extra to him. It looks like he's hurting right now. Whoa, 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 oh, I've been knocked stupid. He had, if you notice, he was taking some lingering damage, so that oil may be doing what I need it to do right now. Oh, straight up the sphincter. How you like them apples there? Ecky. How you like them apples? Oh, watch it now. Damn, the shields are down. Gonna have to drink a tawny owl. Thank you. Oh, he's sensing weakness. He's sensing it. Oh no, look at that. His little spectral. His spectral abilities have worn off there or something. Whether he has to solidify to attack or not, I'm not sure. Could be the case. The trap definitely does the job though. Oh, and he's done. He's done. All right, let's get a good look at this creature. Well, oh, kind of tough to tell with the cat vision on, you know. Anyway, lesser red mutagen, take it. Some monster hair, a little monster blood, a monster ear, a monster eye. And an Ekimara hide. Alright. Well, I think what we'll do is I'm going to head right in. We'll get a good read up on his ass here. What are we looking at? Well, what was I thinking he was? Elementa. No, there's nothing new. Vampire? Was he? Oh, hell, he was. Look at this thing. And we get a clearer picture of him. That's one fantastic beard, sir. Is that a beard? Or is that saliva of some kind dripping down? I don't know. Anyway, Ekimaras. Bah, ain't nothing to fear. Ekimaras, why, they ain't nothing more than overgrown bats. All right, so that's what he's supposed to be. All right. Like other vampires, Ekimaras are not, despite what village gossips might say, undead humans. They are instead post-conjunction monsters who have no particular feelings about garlic, holy water, or your run-of-the-mill religious symbols, yes. Unlike their portrayals in ballads and legends, they look nothing like handsome, pale aristocrats with charming eastern accents. Though like catechins and nucarats, they do bear a strong resemblance to overgrown bats. They also do not suck blood from the necks of virgins with a delicate kiss-like bite. No, instead they tear them to shreds using long, sharp claws and then slurp the splattered blood off the ground. Well, you don't say. Anyway, alright, so definitely the Igni sign and vampire oil. Okay, so I definitely dabbed a little bit of the wrong oil on there, but no harm done. We came out victorious on this night, and a little devil's puffball, what he's weak against. Okay. What did it cost me there? Two swallows. Tawny owl. Did I guzzle two swallows? I'm not even sure. Was it one or two? It was definitely one. Oh, grab that. And the Slaughter of Sintra. Wow. I'll have to have a read. Oh, we could have some buried away treasure here. Careful now. You could have perhaps... Oh my, this may have been a... Oh! What is that now? This may have been a foolish choice here, Witcher. We've got Wraith action over here. Nothing that can't be handled, clearly. Come on, Wraithy. I'm ready for you. A little spectral oil on there. Get my Igni ready. Where is he? Cutting into him. Is he done? Not quite. Oh, damn. Coming in with a big combo on me. There we go. Now he's done for. Kind of foolish. Oh, now look at this. I'll tell you, this flammable gas appears to be seeping in quite quickly. Do I even have free passage through here? I'd almost say no, I don't. We'll see here. See if we can burn it away. Of course, we need to loot up our specter. All right. Well, you know what? Screw this. Whoa, it's coming back already. Oh, dang. If I go down that tunnel, it's going to be a real commitment, you know. because you know that gas is coming in fast. It's coming in fast. Let's search the rest of this chamber first before I move forward. I don't even know if I want to venture down there. Could be a death trap. Could be a dead end, you know, with just noxious gas or the flammable shit just keeps pumping into the chamber, you know. Anyway, we got an old sheepskin. Here we go. Witcher George's journal. We've got Griffin armor diagram, trousers, boots, and the gauntlets to go with it. Scavenger hunt for the Griffin school gear. Well. You can see we're missing two pieces. I need to read George's notes. What is that I heard? This one, I just heard something. At this point, I've lost my cat eye. Lots of candles here, you know. Look at that. Fantastic. Shine a little light on the... Oh, there's actually... Okay. I'll tell you, I wish I'd known. I could have saved myself a cat. It sounds so strange saying it like that. What did you do with this cat? This cat, Geralt. What did you do with it? He cooked it up and ate it, kids. Yes, he did. Terrible bitch, huh? That's why the townsfolk are wary of your kind. Alright. Oh. Our Ekamar here was a real drunkard, yes. A fan of the drink, clearly. He had, even had an olive in there, so he was clearly fixing up some martinis in his spare time, yes. Anyway, that's kind of funny. Alright. Some bison grass, really. We've missed a few candles here. There you go, betcha. Oh, laying waste to his, clearly this is his bed, his sarcophagus. We've got ballads and hymns and a little more booze. Yeah, he really was a bit of a drunkard, wasn't he? Some honeycomb. Alright. He was a real mixologist, this Ekamaras. Because clearly he was using the honeycomb for some fantastic beverage, yes. Is that everything? It looks like it. No, we got a few more mushrooms down here. Alright, now the question really does become, do I push forward? Here's the first thing I'm going to do. We're going to get that swallow in. And actually, I guess what I want to do is I want to read Witcher George's notes, right? Okay. Or his journal. Let's have a look here. Alright, from the mouse, from the pen. From the feathered, from the inked feather, yes, of Witcher George, yes. Having heard rumors of a dragon, I raced at full speed to Velen. Sadly, I was dragged away from my hunt by the prefects of Gorsvelin. Yes, they summoned me as an expert to solve the riddle of a string of shipwrecks, suspected to be the work of night wraiths. Seems a dragon ravaging the countryside is a lower priority these days than blocked trade routes. Luckily, I was able to solve the riddle of the lone lighthouse quickly, and raced off after the dragon. I learned that the peasants from the ravaged villages had taken shelter in the elven catacombs under Lake Vindamir. Wise, yes, truly wise. Yet they were not wise enough to bring firewood, and so warmed themselves by burning elven manuscripts. Oh my, the horror. What knowledge was lost, yes. It aches my heart to think what knowledge about the older folk went up in those flames. At least a few of the manuscripts survived, including some highly interesting sketches of armor. Yet enough about that. Eyewitnesses have reported ashen scales, height at haunches, 2 fathoms. Length, 5 fathoms. Addendum. Estimated weight, approximately 14 quintals. Truly, he is a magnificently large creature. It will maintain a high temperature in its bellows. The dragon lungs. For the layman, yes. for longer than a quarter hour. Conclusion, we are dealing with a green dragon. Commencing hunt. Alright, so, I don't know what the big purpose of that was, other than the fact that it told, you know, an interesting chapter. It recounted an interesting chapter in the life and times of Witcher George. Okay, so, well, it's been updated. Find all the Drygrams, right? Search the ruins of the fortress. I'm looking at the right side of the screen here. Search the ruins of the fortress by the lighthouse, and search the Lord's Castle. Let's take a look at the map and see exactly where these are. See if they are nearby. I'm not really seeing anything. Alright, we've got something. Alright, that's up by Oxenfurt. Okay, and I'm way down here. And I'm not seeing... Oh, here we go. Here's the other one, way over here. Okay, well, that's gonna have to wait. You know. Despite the fact I would love a full set of, you know, Griffin armor. Witcher school Griffin-styled armor. It's just gonna have to wait. I've got more pressing matters here in the bog. So, let's head over to the journal and reassign. What do I want here? A swamp thing. Let's get that up there. Come on now. Track it up. Alright, now. Okay, so I've read Witcher George's journal. Let's get a quick meditation in here. Should I try and take us to dawn? It may be a smart choice here. Let this night pass us by. It may, you know, in case there are any more vampires lurking about, it may be a smart choice. Although it was made mention that the Ekamaras have no real weakness to, well, what was it? Garlic, I think holy water, maybe religious artifacts. I don't know if sunlight was mentioned at all, you know. Anyway, quick saving it. Quick saving it. I think everything's been searched. We have cleaned out this vampire nightclub, yes, of all its booze. Alright, well, I'll tell you, we're not going up here torch in hand, Bitcher. That's just foolish. Just foolish, sir. We're gonna have to drink another cat, and that's fine by me. And you're gonna have to be at your best here, sir. Alright. Start off a massive chain reaction. The problem is that if any baddies are spring up down here. Oh, damn. If any baddies spring up, and I'm forced to do battle, and I get stuck in this gas as it returns. Oh, dang. I'd be in just a world of hurt. Alright, there we go. We're through.
Come on.
Oh, nice. Damn you, Wraith. You will suffer my wrath. Oh, no. Oh, that's gonna hurt. Oh, I'm not stupid. I took the shields. I think I'm probably gonna get the better of them here, though. There we go. The Wraith is fallen. We got a few mushrooms, some puffball, and of course, the Wraiths, they always have some good dusts on them, you know? Some Spectre dust, some Amethyst dust, and some Essence of Wraith. That's the other ingredient they often give. You know, this is really turning into some one hell of an expansive underground dungeon. Some old ruin here we've stumbled onto. I really hope there's an alternate exit, because I don't feel like working that one tunnel again. Because as you can see, just at a quick glance, all of that crap has seeped back into the chamber, you know. Okay. Shields up, Vitcher. As we press on. Yet another Wraith here. I better get the Spectre Oil on. Oh no, I've still got some on there. 6 shots left with it. Alright. We're okay. Die already, Wraith. Thank you. Gotta watch out for their triple shot combo. That's a real killer. A real headache. A real pain in the ass, yes. Burn! Burn, baby, burn. Okay. Get my precious ingredients. Some emerald dust. There we go. And Wraith Mutagen, I'll take that. waiting for, I'm really waiting for some sort of a Wraith decoction to come in, because we've got a couple of Wraith, I've got a couple of Wraith mutagens at this point, you know. Alright. Oh my. This thing sounds surly. Dang, how many are in here? The thing's teleporting all over the place, super fast. Super fast. Gonna need the swallow. There's a pair of them in here, I think. Oh no. One down. Working wonders here in my little trap. There we go. Nope! Second one not quite bested just yet. There we go, and that's all she wrote. Got 40 seconds left on my cat vision. Try and make quick work of the rest of this area if I can. Not gonna hurt me to just simply guzzle another one, though. Alright. I'll take all of that. Oh, there's some loot here. Wolf hide, thread, leather scraps, meteorite ore, dimeridium ore, and a little wine stone. Glowing ore, dimeridium plate, some hides. Good for selling. Great for making coin off these hides. Great for making coin. And even more loot yet. Look at this. Crystallized essence, ducal water. Okay. That'll be good for going up against vampires. Journeyman weapon repair kit, very nice, because the other journeyman kit I had is actually for armor, you know, so that's cool. We've got the reliever's decoction here, manuscript. Sidarian gambeson, cool, silk, fifth essence, florins and crowns, good. Okay, the cat potion is done. Has run its course. Alright, here we go. Here's hoping for something good. Meteorite ore. A few hides. Diagram for Hunter's Gauntlets. And Enhanced Dancing Star. Okay. Oh, we got another Journeyman's... I think it was a weapon repair kit. So that's good. I got a couple of them now. That's good. That's a weight off my mind, you know. Because being able to repair the silver sword in the field is really is essential, you know. At least at this point, since I don't have a backup blade. I think that's everything. And my God, is it ever dark in here? Maybe I should go with the glowing lamp. You know, it's a softer light, but I think it actually. I think it drifts a little further, you know, the light carries a little further. Alright, there's what was left of that other foul wraith that thought it could get the better of Witcher Geralt on this eve. Actually, no, it's dawn now at this point, isn't it? Alright, let's try this here. Oh yeah, this is far more illuminating, you know. But, unfortunately, my speed is limited. I can't run worth a damn. Alright, good. Not even gonna need the lamp at this point. We have spilled out to the countryside. I'll tell you, the main entrance was really tucked away. You know, almost as well as, how am I getting out of here now? I'll tell you, better not have to go back through there just to get out. Come on, there you go. Pull yourself up, Geralt. Good man. This was almost as well tucked away, just as well as the illusion, you know, the illusioned cave, the rear entrance. Okay, let's take a look at the map and see where we've ended up here now. Oh well, what do you know? We've come out at the other point of interest that I had intended to inspect, the Dragonslayer's Grotto, as it's known. Okay, well now we'll head south, we'll travel down here, and hopefully, well, meet up with Leslov. I have to guess that he's gonna be down here at this location, keeping some sort of a vigil. Yes, keeping a watchful eye on this swamp thing, making sure it stays confined to the bog. All right, grab a little wolf's bane. No, I don't really need it, and we'll call in old Roche. Set off by horse. I guess, for the time being, let me get, because I am sitting about half health right now. We'll mount up, and I've got quite a bit of honeycomb here. I could maybe... maybe help myself to some of that. What I'll do is I'll drink one of them right now. We'll get the honeycomb in there. We'll mount up on Roche. We'll set off with our beer goggles on, yes. With our blurred vision. Oh, wow. I'll tell you, that Ekemaris had some mighty potent booze down there in that cave. I don't remember the vision being quite so... Oh, quite so functified. Well, I need to grab that. The Celandine's a must-have. It's a must-stop ingredient, you know. All right.
That's it, Roach.
Just want to get my health back up.
Move it.
I hear rats. I'll tell you, I hope we haven't ventured back down towards the, that big earth elemental, you know.
Let's go.
He could very well be the swamp thing. I don't know. I'm not sure. He was marked with double question marks, though, so I don't know. I've got some sort of a baddie over here.
Whoa!
Oh, water hag. All right. Looking for trouble, are you? Is that what that is? No, that's a necker. Damn neckers. No, it's a foglet. Oh, no. Watch it now, bitcha. Where is he? He's around here somewhere. There we go. That's that. Now I remember. That's his great counter. Oh, and he's done just like that. Oh, wow, there was actually a pair of them there. Oh, they're playing with your mind, Vetcher. He actually leaves a trail of fog behind, too. I don't know.
Well, come on.
Like, I don't know if y'all noticed, but the fog seemed to get really thick as he was moving around the area. You know, pretty cool. Pretty cool. And it's the little things that matter, you know. It's all of those little things that add up to just create a great experience. Okay, lesser blue mutagen, let's take it. Roche still, well, he didn't seem too pleased. I heard him crying out in terror, afraid of this foglet. Oh no, two more in fact. Where is he? His great weakness, it really is. Oh, I killed him. How many are over here? I don't even want to guess. You know? Geralt's lost his combat stance. Perhaps the last one fled quite wisely. I don't know. Let's get a little honeycomb in. Yeah, there's still something. A pair of them, in fact. Actually, these are drowners now. Oh, damn. We've got a good posse of them as well. Oh, almost too many. Almost too many. Geralt, just back up. Just back up. Oh, wow. There's a foglet over here attacking Roche. God damn it. Oh, there's a pair of them, in fact. That's where they went. Ridiculous. Nice. He tried to save his buddy, but it was simply was too late. Too little too late, Foglet. And he's disappeared yet again. Waiting for me to leave the area so he can harass the horse. Clearly they've got a good taste for the horse meat. Yes, these foglets. It's probably a delicacy, yes. Amongst their kind. Alright, well, I don't know if I really want to go back over there and battle those damn drowners. I'm in no mood for their shenanigans. Truly. First things first, let me get that magic lamp off of there. I left a little something behind. Here we go. Well, I am gonna head back over here, and we will deal with these drowners. I just hope that I can isolate them, you know. The pack of four or five is just, can really be overwhelming. Here we go, getting swarmed. He's still hurting from our last encounter. Good. Easy pickings, I like it. Where's he gone now? Here he comes. Oh, there's a pair. Oh, there's a trio. Oh my. They just continue to materialize out of nothingness. Unless he's, unless it's just one and he's got like some kind of, oh no, that's not good. Oh no, there's definitely a pair here. At the very least, trio. There's a trio. You know, this is the first time I've ever encountered them, like, in a pack like this. Oh, dang. Get out of there, Vitcher. Damn it, man. Alright. Shields are back up. Done. What's left? I mean, that was only one. As quickly as they arrive on the scene, they seem to disappear, you know. Done, Drowner. Drowner coming in, trying to capitalize on a weakened Vetcher. Wasn't gonna happen, sir. Gonna have to drink my other swallow, I don't know. This is, going through stuff. Going through my potions quite quickly here. In this little corner of the world. Here comes one of the buggers. Where is he? Hiding in a tree of all things. Well, that and a cloud of fog. There we go. Done. The great equalizer. I love it. Did you notice how the mist kind of spread out all around me as I killed him? Perhaps as I simply snatched life from him. Sent his essence floating along the winds. I don't know. Alright, well. Have we gained much ground on this swamp thing? No. Foglet country, right there, people. Beware, yes. Incredible. There were so many of them there. I'm probably gonna have to get a meditation. Probably a smart choice here. God damn it. Don't want to do it. But, the Vitcher, he needs a little rest after battle. Yes. Alright. Faster. Let's roll on out. Can he cross here? I hope so. Yeah, barely. Barely. Just ride it hard there, Roche. Reckless abandon, horrors. Thank you. Okay. Appears as though we're rolling up on something. Leslov has clearly been driven mad by the swamp thing, yes.
Whoa.
Life in the bog has taken its toll on the man. He's now arguing with himself. Not a good sign, Leslov. Not a good sign at all, sir.
Careful, sir. A monster prowls the bog. Enter the mist and you'll never see home again.
Tell me about this monster, Leslov. You ask, perhaps, how I know your name. Well, it's because I saw your notice, yes, in Downwarren.
This monster, tell me more.
Only seen it once myself, and that from afar and past dusk. Thought it were a man at first. Then it turned, and I saw eyes burning like coals and a jaw full of fangs, one next to the other.
Oh.
Humanoid, nocturnal. First attack. Remember when it happened?
A week passed, near about. It was then Boren vanished. Merrick and Tomil went looking for him, didn't come back either, them two. I were afeared. Now none dare venture into the bog. Camp stands deserted, and the peat there, master, it's the best sort. Black as pitch and oily. Good for fuel and...
Fascinating, but staying with the topic at hand.
You know, I have to wonder, the description on this creature was quite similar to the description on what took down the Baron's wife, you know? And so we could be dealing with clearly a similar beast, you know? Anyway, I can help, Leslov. I promise I will. I can guarantee you success, sir. Of course, it will cost you. It will come at the cost of a small fee.
Assume you put up the notice in Down Warren.
Aye, twere me. Good to know someone reads them. Paid a scribe a dozen eggs to write it up.
I can help. For a fee.
Course! Why, even an ox don't pull a plow for free.
How much, let's discuss this price, sir. Let's discuss this fee.
Afraid I'll need more than an ox needs. How much are you willing to pay, exactly?
Oh, not too bad, not too bad. I think we can probably tip the scales in our favor against... the weak-minded Leslov here, yes. As I said, he's lost a little bit of his edge here in the swamps as the years have gone by. I'm gonna push 315 here. No. 316 would have put it over the top, Vitcher. 315 is, I think, the max we're gonna get here. Let's try it.
I mine peat, not gold, Master. Could never pay that much in my life.
Oh, damn it. And he's quite annoyed. Good Lord. He took half the bar there. He's getting ready to just walk away and deal with the swamp thing himself, Vitcher. All right, better scale her back a hefty ways here. We'll go 272 here. Yes. Hopefully that will make him happy.
That I simply do not have.
Damn it, man.
Would a few crowns less satisfy you?
Would... Fine. Vitcher, it appears you are fucked, so we'll go 269 and see what that does. I mean, my God, sir. Why even bother bartering if you're just gonna shoot down every price I bloody well give you?
That I simply do not ask.
Really?
Would a few crowns less satisfy you?
Well, fine. 260, and that's my final offer. And if you don't accept this, Leslov, I'm walking away, you screwball.
Oh, Master, you value your services dear. But so be it. I'll agree to that.
You better. You earned yourself an extra 18 crowns out of this, Vitcher. Be proud, yes. Hold your head high. Anyway, let's, I guess the time I got to work, isn't it? Yeah. Earn myself this money.
All right, time I got to work. Where'll I find this monster?
Start south of here. But beware, bad poxy air hangs o'er the marsh. Stings your eyes, claws at your throat. Claws so hard you could choke.
I don't like the sound of that swamp thing. You know, with all those foglets around, maybe it has something to do with a foglet. I don't know. But whatever it is, and whatever we do, it's gonna have to wait until next episode. Look at that tree up there. Look at that thing. What are we staring at exactly? Let's have a look. Well, I don't know what that is. It's quite the growth, though. Oh, my. Quite the ancient tree, I would say. Anyway, people, appreciate you stopping on in for this episode. I hope you had a good time. We battled the elusive Ekimara. Yes, vampire extraordinaire. We earned our title as Mountain Man this episode as well, yes. And did battle against the mists and foglets of Crookback Bog. Next episode, we're gonna follow through on this Witcher contract and try and take down this swamp thing. And of course, we've still got pressing work and pressing matters with the crones of Crookback Bog and the poor people of Down Warren as we try to figure out what it is exactly that has brought about this darkness. And in fact, we try to discover and uncover and what the very nature of this darkness is. Anyway, people, it's all going to happen next episode and beyond, and so I hope to see you there. But of course, until then, remember why it hurts. Later, all.